Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to learn how to integrate ChatGPT APIs in our Spring Boot application. So as we know, nowadays ChatGPT is a most popular term, and I believe you are aware about what ChatGPT does for us. We can ask anything to ChatGPT and he will provide the answer for it. And you might be familiar with the term prompt in the ChatGPT. In the context of ChatGPT or similar language model, a prompt is referred to provide the input or initial text provided by the user to generate a response. So we can see simple text is it's used for prompt. So it is the text or query that you input into the model to get the relevant output. And the prompt is essentially serve as a instruction to a starting point for the language model to understand and generate the response. So what is ChatGPT? ChatGPT is a type of generative AI that allows user to input prompts and receive the output in the form of human-like images, text or videos, and all generated by artificial intelligence. So here we will see how ChatGPT works. So let me open ChatGPT first. So here we can see ChatGPT is using model 3.5, and it is the prompt. Here we can provide our input. So let me ask something from ChatGPT. So what is Spring Boot? So like this, ChatGPT will generate the response that is human readable. So let me go. So here we can see the response provided by ChatGPT. Spring Boot is an open source Java based framework developed by Pivotal Software that simplifies the process of building and deploying enterprise grade. So like this, we can get the response from our ChatGPT. But is it possible to integrate this ChatGPT API in our Spring Boot application? Yes, it is possible. So we will do this. So okay, let's start implementation. So first I will create one new project. start.spring.io. And here I will just select the version, Java, language, project type Maven, and Spring Boot version is 3.2.1. And here I will select dependency, web dependency. Another, we can add Lombok, so we no need to write any setter getter for any property. So here I have added just two dependencies. Here we can give the group name, and artifact name is ChatGPT demo generate. So here I have imported the project into our IntelliJ. So it's downloading plugins for ChatGPT demo. So here I have imported the project into IntelliJ, and this is the structure, that is a simple Spring Boot project. But before integrating any third party API like ChatGPT, we need to know the request and response model of API and what is the endpoint that we need to call. So let me go back and check the response and request model for ChatGPT API. So okay, now let's go to and open its home page. So here I will just type platform open API playground, and just need to open AI platform. So here we can see it is the playground that we can use to check its request and response model. So here I will go and click on chat, and if we have already ChatGPT account, then it will okay. Otherwise we need to create it. And we can login. So here I will just enter a message, what is Spring Boot, and we'll just submit this question and query, so it will provide me the response. So now let me go and check the view code area. So we can check the code is here, and this is a curl request, and we can just copy this request from here and just copy and go to our Postman. And here I will open just import and paste the curl request. So here we can see this is our REST endpoint and request HTTP method is post, and here we can see body, and inside body we can see here we can see we have passed message and role, and in content we are getting the response, and this is the temperature, max token, topi, frequency penalty and presence penalty. So same model we are using to get the request and response. So here we can see this is our query, what is Spring Boot, and submitted by user, and this is the response that we received from ChatGPT. So here we are getting the role as assistant. So like this we can identify what is the request we have sent and what is the response we are getting from ChatGPT. So this is the request which we are passing to get the response from OpenAI completion API. Model and messages are mandatory parameters to be included in the API request. So model, this parameter designate the version of the model to which request will be sent. So there are multiple and various models. So we are just using ChatGPT 3.5 model. And here is the second field is messages, and messages serve as prompt for the model. So each message comprises two essential fields, role and content. The role field specifies the message sender and denoted as user in the request, and in response it will be assistant. In the request it will be user role, and in the response it will be assistant. And the content field contains the actual content. So here below we can see there are some more fields, that is temperature. So the default value of it's 1 and it should be within the range of 0 to 2. So this parameter regulates the randomness of the response. So higher value increase randomness, whereas lower value enhance focus and determinism. Like there is one field is max tokens. By default there is no limit, but this parameter allow you to specify the maximum number of tokens to generate in the response. Now we know the request and response model of our ChatGPT API. So let me remove this role part and that we are getting in the response. So from here I have removed this, and let me execute this REST endpoint, but we will get error. So let me check what we are getting. So here we are getting incorrect API key provided. So if I will go to body, in the header we can check the authorization part. Here we can see we have not provided any open API key. So if we want to execute this API and get the response in our Postman, so we need to provide the valid API key. So let me go to browser and generate the OpenAI key. So this is the request response model. So here your API key can be found here. So let me click here and it will open new tab. So here I will just click on create a new secret key. So after clicking on create new secret key, here I will give the name my test key. So it will ask about this puzzle, so we need to solve this. So once the verification will complete, it will generate, and we just need to copy this from here. And let me go back to Postman. And here I will go to authorization part. So here let me select bearer token, and here we just need to paste the value here, and let me send the request from here. So it will take time to gather the response. So here we can see the response that we are getting. So this is the response that we received. So this is our response model that we received here. So if we want to integrate this ChatGPT API in our Spring Boot application, then we need to create these all request and response model in our project or in our application. So let me copy this. and go back to browser. So here I will just call Pojo to JSON. So it will generate the request and response model for me. Just open JSON schema to Pojo. So here I will just paste plain JSON object, and here I will give the name chat GPT request, and here I will select the source type is JSON, Jackson 2.x, and here is double number include getter setter also. So if we want to remove, we can remove it because we have Lombok allow additional property, no it required, so we can remove. So just can preview or we can zip. So let me copy this from here. Let me create one model package. Right click, new package. So we can give model. So here I will create class, new Java class, ChatGPT request. And from here I will just copy this request model. Let me copy this and paste it here. So here we can remove this annotation also. And here we can use @data annotation because we have removed setter getter. So this is the ChatGPT request. So we need to import message class also. So let me go back and check the another class, that is message, and go back to our project. Let me create one another model, that is message Java class message, and we'll need to copy this code from here. So let me go back to IntelliJ and paste it here. So here I will remove @generated and use @data. So it will automatically add setter getter method. Like this, we can add another annotation of Lombok, @allr constructor and @knower constructor. According to our requirement, we can add. So let me copy it and go back here and just paste this. So here it's showing some error. So let me see. So we need to remove this also. Same, we are getting the message class. So let me go back to message and just remove this import, that is not required. So here our ChatGPT request is ready. So we also need to create ChatGPT response. So let me copy it from here and we'll use same JSON to Pojo schema and close it and just paste this response model here as a JSON object that we received. So here I will give the name ChatGPT response. So let me generate. So here is the choice class that we need to create. So let me go back to our IntelliJ. New Java class choice and just copy this properties, go back and paste here, remove this one, @data, @allr constructor, @knower constructor, and remove this import that is not useful. So go back, scroll down, and here we can see another class, that is message. But message class we have already created while creating request, so we can check here. So if I will go here, so here we can see message class is already created. Here is two field, role, and second is content. So no need to create it again. So check me another class, that is usage. New class, usage. So need to copy these lines. So here we just need to add a grid data annotation. So after that we will go back and check the main class, that is ChatGPT response. So let me copy and create here. So now our all classes are ready. Request and response model is created. So here it's showing some compile time error. So we just need to remove this unused import. So now everything is ready that we required to integrate our ChatGPT API in our Spring Boot application. So let me create one controller class, one controller package. So let me create one package first, ChatGPT demo. So here I will click on package dot controller, and inside this controller I will create one controller class, custom chatbot controller, and inside this controller I will define rest endpoint. So first I will define the annotation at the rate rest controller, and here I will create one API, that is get type, get mapping. So this will be the URL path for this API. Public string, we can return all the whole response, or we can just return the specific response that we want to show to the user. If you want to return whole ChatGPT response object, then we can, then our return type will be ChatGPT response. So first I will try with ChatGPT response. So we will return whole object that we will receive. And here we will pass, so here we can pass the parameter like message from here. So we can just pass this message from here, or we can use request param also if we don't want to define here, but here I am using @path variable annotation to read this message. So from here I will just return the response. I will not create more service classes. So we can return null or ChatGPT response. So our rest endpoint is ready. So we need to define or integrate our ChatGPT API now. So as we know, to call third party API we need to use REST template or web client to integrate with third party API. So here I will create one config package, and inside this config package I will just create one class for configuration. So here I will create OpenAI config class, open AI config, and at class level I will define annotation at the rate configuration. So it will read at the time of startup of application, and here I will just create the bean of REST template, but we also need to integrate with OpenAI key. So I will go here in application.properties file, and here I will just define one property, OpenAI.key. And here I will just paste the value of OpenAI key that we have copied.
So let me go back into IntelliJ, and here I will just paste it. And now I will go to our OpenAI config class, and here I will create the bean for our REST template. So here I will just create a method public REST template I will use to call third party API. So here we can give the name to this bean. So here I will just provide the template, and here I will just return new REST template without any configuration. It can call to third party API, but here we also need to pass OpenAPI key in the header, so we need to do some more configuration. So here what I will do, I will just create the object for new REST template. So remove this REST template. Template is equal to new REST template, so we need to integrate. So here I will just pass the header from here, template dot get interceptor, and here I will add . So here we need to pass the request. Body and execution. And here I will just call request.getheaders. GetHeaders method. And here we need to add authorization. So here I will just type authorization is the header value, authorization, and here we need to pass the value. So here I will pass bearer, because we need to pass a token as a bearer. We'll add one space here, and here I will just pass open AI key. So that value we can read from our property file. So let me define here @value annotation that we can use to read the value from our property file. So here I will just define $. So here we need to define the same property name, open AI dot key that we have defined in our properties file. So let me check. So here we can just copy and go back to our OpenAI config class and just replace it. And here we can define the name private string OpenAI key. So from here I will just return the execution dot execute method we need to call from here. So here I will pass just request and body. Inside request we have set the header. Now we just need to pass so body, and after that we will just return this template. So our template is ready, so we will return it from here. So this is a configuration that is required. So let me go back to our chatbot controller. So here I will just auto void private REST template. So to call our ChatGPT API, we need to call the endpoint. So this is the REST endpoint that we need to call. So let me copy this endpoint from here, paste it here. So here I will just define string URL. So we can define it inside our property class and can read from there. So this is the request model that we need to create. So let me go to our IntelliJ, and here I will just define chat GPT request. So it is our request model, new ChatGPT request, and by using ChatGPT request we can just create
So here I have created ChatGPT request and I have passed this ChatGPT request here while calling post API, and here I am passing ChatGPT URL, and this is the URL that we are calling, and this is the ChatGPT model that we are using, GPT 3.50 Turbo, and here I am just set the role as user and passing the message from here that we will get from our path variable. So let me start and test if our API is working fine or not. So let me run this application. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. So let me go back to browser. And from here I will just call localhost 8080 bot what is Spring Boot, so here we can see the response that we received from ChatGPT. So let me copy this, and here we can go to JSON viewer and check the response. So this is the response that we received from our own API after integration with ChatGPT. So inside choices we can see one object, and inside this object this is the message that we received. Content: Spring Boot is a Java based open source framework that is used to create standalone, or we can directly call this API from our Postman also. So let me go back and create here new tab, just paste it here. What is Spring Boot, and send. So here it's taking time to gather the response. So here this is the response that we received from our ChatGPT API after integration. So this is the role assistant that you are getting in the response, and this is the content. And in the request, as we know, we have just passed two parameter, one is model and second is message, because these are mandatory that we need to pass. So here we can see in our chatbot controller class we have passed the message and model. So like this we can integrate ChatGPT API in our Spring Boot application. So here we have defined direct value, but we can use @grade value annotation also to read the ChatGPT URL and ChatGPT model from our property files. So here are the multiple things that we can achieve using OpenAPI completion API with modes in ChatGPT. So it is natural language generation, and it's a text summarization, and it always return the response, and that is language translation for we can use, and we can also use for text completion. And we can also use this ChatGPT application to for question answering. We will ask any question, it will return the answer. And we can also use ChatGPT API to generate the code. So it will provide our the code example if we will ask any code. That we can also use in generate poetry, stories or other creative content. And it is also educational assistance as a provide, because it provides explanation and answers to students questions or help with. It is also useful in case of content recommendations. It suggest content, product or services to user based on their preference and queries. And it is also useful in drafting emails or documents, because it assists in composing emails, reports or other written documents. So there are just some examples that we can achieve with OpenAI completion API and models like ChatGPT. Okay, thanks for watching this video.